Hey, what's up guys? Nunu here. For the last 3 months, D5 Render users participated with their entries in the D5 Render Challenge 2. This year's theme was How Far Would You Go? In the past, people were in lockdown and the renders could help you travel anywhere you can imagine. As one of the judges, I had the honor to help select the best entries for the challenge. And in today's video, I will give my review of the winners of the challenge. And so this is the first render, it's the Pluto Stratum by Michael Powell. And let's start just by showing you a short clip of this entry. So now that we saw that, I just want to point out here some things. The assets that is using, it says that you use ground rocks from Quixel. So Quixel is a website where you can find a lot of extremely high quality assets. They are using photogrammetry. Basically, they are taking a lot of photos around the object and then making this into 3D. So it's very realistic, and you'll find assets from rocks, plants, textures, a lot of things you'll have there. And then it says that the background images from Unsplash and iVideo from Pexels. Both these websites are for stock photos and video. And so you can even go to these websites to find, for example, background images for your render. You just type there, for example, city panorama, and you will find a lot of images there for this purpose. And it says that everything else is from D5. So now let's have a look to the images. This project, I really like it because it shows that you can do with D5 render other things other than the architectural visualization, right? You don't need to do like an interior or a new apartment complex. You can also do things like it was the purpose of this challenge. You can really take your imagination to these places. And for this one, it really looks like a dystopian future. Maybe it's like a scene from the book 1984. It's what it reminds me. And I really like these images. This one, I think it's quite nice. I would probably just crop it a little bit here on the bottom to keep the proportion of 16:9. And it will help a little bit with a rule of thirds. But overall, I really like the composition here and the mood that it has. This one, it's using here the particles from D5. And it's one of the things that I think D5 could still improve. The particles don't look super realistic. But with a video, it will be difficult to use other assets here. And I think he's using as well some fog elements here. And overall, it's nice. The technique he used, the lighting, everything looks really nice with this dark futuristic look. So going to one of the second place, and this one is Far Away in My Tiny Paradise from Nicholas Millett. And so let's first watch a little bit of the video. Checking here the source assets, it says that he used most of the models are self-made. And this one, it's a really stylized render. Again, as I said previously, you can create different types of styles with D5. And this one reminds me a lot of a video game called Firewatch. It had this similar style with these stylized low poly assets. And let's just watch a little bit more. Here I don't have much to comment because it was really a art direction to go with this style. I think overall it looks quite nice. Even here the light with the fire, I think it's quite good. It still keeps the mood of the scene. So overall, I think Nicholas did a nice job here. And now let's move to the first place, which is from Great to Color from Michal. I'm hope I'm pronouncing the name right. If not, I'm sorry. And let's watch first the animation, because I really like what he did here. So the assets that he used was mainly from Sketchfab. He even gave the whole list of the models, so you can also download this list. And I really like this one. It really shows with this door opening that with imagination, you can go anywhere you want. And in terms of the render and artistically, I think it looks really good. All of these models are also very high quality, so it really helps to sell this idea. And there's also another thing that he just didn't put the models and that's it. He used a lot of the puddles that you can see here, all of this new system. And let me just see if I have here a new image. You can see all of these tiny rocks, especially on top here, on top of the cars, all of these rocks. He used from D5, he used the brush tool and start painting there. You can even see on this post, he has the, here on the bottom, he has a making of. So I think it's really good for you to watch the making of. It really helps you to understand all of the process of creating this type of scene. And even explains how he made the door opening and then exploring to going to the other side. I really like this image here. And then this one, it really sells the entry. And now moving to the grand prize. It's called State of Mind by Showing Inspirational. Let's watch the video. So here again, the assets, it says it's self-made and from Quixel. So I already spoke about in the beginning of the video, what is Quixel. And if you haven't checked this website, Quixel, I highly recommend you do it because it really has very good assets that will help you in your production. And this one is really interesting because it says that until the 4 days before closing the date for the challenge, he hasn't made his submission. Just in the very end, he actually had this idea to make this scene. And this one, I'll start opening here some images. So this one, it's the mood of the scene. I think that it looks more like, really like a fairy tale. And you can see the light here just focusing on this area. So the point of focus, it's this. And the tree with these golden leaves as well, it's with the sun shining on them, creates this really nice effect on this scene. And it's not just that, he also had these elements here. Let's say there's some particles, it could be some fireflies, but it really adds to the mood of the scene. So it's all in these details that make your scene look quite good. And so even the composition in all of them, it's really good. Print this one and make it as a poster, because it's this one looks really good. Then you have some small details. The ones that are inside the cave for me are the best ones, because you have this lighting coming just from one place, and the position of the tree and all of these elements are really, really good. And also, by the way, there's one important point here, is using these complementary colors. So you have this blue on the background, right? And then you have this yellow color that complements quite well with the blue. So when you are making your renders, always use this type of colors, like complementary, analogous, try it. You can even go to this website, it's called coloradobe.com. And there, if you put any color, it will show you the complementary, for example, in this case that I'm showing right now, it will show you the complementary color of the one that you put. So with this, you are sure that the colors that you are using are going to work well. So always pay attention to that. So for example, this one, I think it's already with a lot of these sun rays. I don't think it works as well as this one. I really like this one. This one is another one that looks quite well because it's using the symmetry here, as you can see, and also works with these dark areas in contrast with this a lot of light here coming out of the exterior. This is another good example, and here the God rays work quite well. By the way, the God rays is this effect when you have a lot of particles in the air and the sun is shining through them, and it creates this effect that you are seeing here. This one, it's nice as well. So this one, I, for example, in comparison these two shots, I really prefer this one because it, this area here of the cave, this rock, and this rock on the bottom, they help to frame the composition to show us this main part, this main focus here, which is in the middle, these deers here and all of this lighting. So I prefer this shot over this one. What do you think of the renders of this D5 render challenge? Let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to learn more about D5 render, you can watch this video that will help you with your exterior renders, and you can watch also this one here. And I'll see you in the next one.